Hi, I'm Ganesh from AWS.
And I'm Daniel from CMD, and this is my architecture.
So today we are going to discuss about ONC International and their DUKC platform and the serverless architecture that's built. Daniel, why don't you share some insights about this architecture and the use case that you're trying to implement?
Yep, so the DUKC platform helps ships and aged ships to get into port based on reading environment sensors and then processing that data. So the port sensors, there could be various ones like wind, wave, and tide, and they send messages back to Amazon via the MSK service. So we had sensors all over the port coming in and sending messages to MSK.
So assuming that you are giving the pathway to the vessels, this has life-saving benefits, right? So why don't you talk about how the data is ingested, where is it stored, and so on and so forth?
Yep. So from MSK, we then use event source mapping, and a Lambda would read those messages. That would then process them and put them into DynamoDB as the hot storage location. From there, DynamoDB would utilize streams, and streams would send it to Firehose, and then in Parquet format, store the messages into a bucket for historical reasons.
So you mentioned about DynamoDB as the hot storage, right? Are you archiving the data out of it?
Yeah, we're using, by moving the data across, we have a time to live then on any data that resides in DynamoDB. So they, at the moment, retain it for 3 months, and that's good enough for them to use. So when they need to query it, it can go quickly into DynamoDB. If they need to go over that period, they'll then look at going to the historical bucket with S3.
Got it. So you're expiring the data in DynamoDB and then querying this Amazon S3 bucket, right?
Yes.
So once Kinesis processes the data and stores in this historical bucket, how is the user UX flowing across here?
So there's either users or platform that will want to request the data. So they'll come in via API Gateway. API Gateway in turn will call Lambda, and then Lambda has a decision point whether it goes to DynamoDB or will it use Athena to then go to the bucket to query that data. That decision point is based on what volume of data we're requesting and the age of the data it's requesting. So it either goes to Dynamo or it goes to Athena. And then from there, it will go to the bucket to request the data.
Now that we have this UX as well, can you also talk about the prediction layer, these three components?
So they have a prediction service that's in a container. That would utilize messages coming in. So as the data comes in, it feeds into this particular service. And that would then do a prediction and put it inside a bucket for other systems to use it. So it would look and forecast up to 2 weeks worth.
So overall, this is a serverless architecture with some amount of event-driven part to it. Can you also talk about the business benefit that the customer was able to observe through this?
So the use case was to get the speed of the system up. So there was a 30 times increase, as well as a 10 to 15% saving in running. And that was really the benefit they were after. They were after the ability to scale quickly, as well as keep some data segregated between their different clients in different ports.
When you said 30% increase, was it increase in terms of data ingestion?
Yeah, it's 30 times increase. So if they get a mass volume of data due to, you know, sensors going offline and then collating and sending them through, it would automatically scale to handle that and it could easily process the data.
Thank you so much, Daniel. I think this was quite insightful. Thank you all for joining in today. Until next time, this is My Architecture.